true. I got one last video of the day. And actually, the three videos, this being the third, I still have not completely covered my section of graphing rational functions. The next video, which I'll do in a couple of days, will actually tie all of this together and we'll actually make a complete graph. We're going to find slant asymptotes. Okay, we just got done talking about vertical asymptotes. That's where the denominator equals zero and it does not factor out. I just covered a lecture on finding horizontal asymptotes. If the top degree is larger than the bottom, there is no horizontal asymptote. If the degree on top is the same as the degree on the bottom, then the horizontal asymptote will be y equals and then whatever the leading coefficients are. And if the bottom degree is larger, then the horizontal asymptote is always y equals zero. So three basic rules for horizontal asymptotes. In my video, though, I did prove how that actually works or is true with the idea of limits as x approaches infinity. However, with slant asymptotes, they occur when the degree of the numerator is one greater than the degree of the denominator. So in this case, we have a rational equation where the degree on top is 2 and the degree on the bottom is 1. So this graph is going to have two asymptotes. A vertical asymptote at x equals 3, because you can't divide by 0. So there's a vertical asymptote at x equals 3. But because the top degree is larger than the bottom degree by 1, there's also a slant asymptote. So let's try and figure that out. Have you watched a video lately called Long Division? Well, if you haven't, we're going to do it again. So that is how you find slant asymptotes. You find slant asymptotes through division. Now, because we're dividing by a binomial with the degree of 1, you can also shortcut this one by doing synthetic division. But very often with rational functions, you have something a little more complicated on the bottom. So fairly good chance that you might be doing long division instead of synthetic division. So I'm going to show that instead. Plus, students are more comfortable generally with synthetic division. So why not review something that kids might struggle a little bit more with? Okay, so we got x squared plus x minus 6 divided by x minus 3. And when we're done with this, by the way, the slant asymptote is going to be whatever is up here. This equation is going to give us the slant asymptote. So that's why we're doing the long division. So how do you get x, this first term, to kind of running out of good colors here that are bright, so I'll just do it all in white. How do I get this first term to equal this first term? Well, I multiply it by x. So I'm going to place an x up here. I like to stack mine a little bit differently than the textbooks do. I hope that's okay with you. X times x is x squared. That looks like division. And x times negative 3 is negative 3x. And then we're going to subtract down as we do this long division. X minus x is 0, and x minus negative 3 is plus. So 1 plus 3 is equal to 4x. Okay, how do I get this leading term to equal this leading term? Well, I'm going to multiply it by 4. So 4 times x is 4x. And 4 times negative 3 is negative 12. I'm going to go ahead and subtract that and get 0, negative 6 plus 12 is 6. And, okay, there is a remainder there, but this is really what I'm concerned with. We are going to have a slant asymptote of y equals x plus 4. Pretty cool, huh? So, if I want to graph this function, and we're not going to do that completely today because I am running out of time. I got to get going, even though this video now is relatively short. But I'll give you like a setup and give you a guide of how you would start this. Actually, how much time do I have? We've got a lot of time left. Let's see how much we can do. Okay. So, I just erased my slant asymptote. It was y equals x minus 4, I think. Nope, plus 4. Sorry about that. Okay, so we've got a rational function that is undefined at 3, and therefore will have a vertical asymptote at 3. We have a rational function that has a slant asymptote of y equals x plus 4. So this is got a slope of 1. And a y-intercept of 4. So we are crossing, or excuse me, we have an asymptote that crosses the y-axis at 4. And from there, you're going to go up 1 over 1. So up 1 over 1. And here we have a slant asymptote. Okay, so we're only going to do a quick sketch because finding the x-intercept on this was going to be well, new material. I'll just go to the bell rings. So, my iPod alarm. Okay, what do we got here? We got, let's find the y-intercept. That's a good point to find when you're graphing. So the y-intercept is found when x equals 0. So if I take this function and I plug in 0, we're going to have 0 squared plus 0 minus 6 over 0 minus 6, 3. And negative 6 divided by negative 3 is 2. So this graph is going to cross the y-axis at 2. All right, let's find the x-intercept. The x-intercept is when y equals 0. So when is this function going to equal zero? When's y going to be zero? What does x have to be to make this entire function equal to zero? Well, let's talk about fractions for a second. I do not want the bottom to equal zero, but if the top equals zero, 0 divided by 10? 0. 0 divided by 5? 0. 0 divided by 100? 0. So when I find with rational functions, when I'm looking for an x-intercept, when I'm trying to get y equal to zero, all I really care about is the top. So I'm going to take the top of this function and pull it out and say, well, what's going to make x squared plus 6 or plus x minus 6 equal to 0? Well, that's going to be x plus 3 and x minus 2. So my x-intercepts are negative 3 and 2. So negative 3 and 2. So even though I was a little reluctant to give you a decent sketch of this graph, it's not actually taking that much time. This graph is going to come up, and from this, from the bottom of this slant asymptote, I know it's on the bottom because all these points are on the bottom, it's going to come up through here, pass to this y-intercept, and then come down against this vertical asymptote that we got from the denominator, which is x equals 3. Now, what happens on the other side? Well, the fact that there's no other x-intercepts gives me an idea that it's probably up here, but I'm not going to know that unless I take the time to do a t-table and try and fill in the part of the graph that we don't yet understand. Now, remember, I just did the y-intercept and the x-intercept. So what's happening to the right of the vertical asymptote of x equals 3? Well, let's plug in x equals 4 and see what we get. I'm just doing like a t-table. So we get f of 4 is equal to 4 squared plus 4, should be using parentheses, minus 6 over 4 minus 3. Well, that's going to be 16 plus 4 minus 6 over 4 minus 3, which is 1, so that's 20 20 minus 16, 6 is 14. So at x equals 4, we're all the way up at 14. So we're way, way up here. Now, you really should have more than one point to make a graph. So let's try 5, and hopefully the numbers aren't too ridiculously big. And that should be enough to let us see what's going to happen. So at x equals 5, we get 5 squared plus 5 minus 6 over 5 minus 3, that's 25, plus 5 minus 6 over 2, that's 30. Now it's 24, and 24 divided by 2 is 12, so there was a little bit of a drop. So at x equals 5, there's a little bit of a drop. But I'll tell you from experience, this is going to come up and then approach and slide up the top of that asymptote, whereas down here is at the bottom. So really there needs to be a little more information to make a good graph, like is it symmetric to the y-axis, which means is it even? Is it got rotational symmetry to the origin because it's odd? But a little more than I plan on doing in this video, but there you go. If your top degree is larger by 1, you do have a slant asymptote, you find it with long division. Vertical asymptotes come usually from when the denominator is equal to 0. If the denominator is equal to 0, remember sometimes that could give you a hole. The top degree was larger, so there was no horizontal asymptote. And I found the x-intercepts and the y-intercepts and plotted a couple of extra points. And that was supposed to be just for slant asymptotes. I hope I helped you out some. There will be a video coming where we do a bunch of these from start to end, right from scratch, get all the important points, talk all about the asymptotes again. All right, I'm out of here. Go do your homework.